Good morning, students. In this video, we are going to see the numerical problems on the flange sections. In the previous theory, we have seen the theory behind this flange sections. So once again, let me revise how we are going to solve this problem or how it has to be solved further. First is that for a flange section, what we do, first we'll try to find out whether the neutral axis, whether it is going to lie in the flange or in the web. For example, if this is one T section, I'll draw. If this is a tree section, first we have to find out whether the neutral axis, it is going to lie within the flange. This is the flange section we have. Whether the neutral axis is lying somewhere in the flange or whether it is lying going to lie within the web section. So now how to find out this? So for that we have to find out total compression. That is, first what we'll assume is, we'll assume that neutral axis, it is going to lie at the bottom of the flange. So based on that, total compression is given by 0.36 fck into bf into df. Total tension, it is given by fts is equal to 0.87 f of I into ast. So for example, if this ftc, if it is greater than fts, FTC is greater than FTS, that means neutral axis, it is going to lie in the flange. If FTC, if it is equal to FTS, that is total tension, neutral axis is going to lie at the bottom of the flange. If FTC, if it is less than FTS, neutral axis is going to lie in the web. So based on these three conditions, we can tell whether the neutral axis is going to lie within the flange or within the web. So after doing this, we have to find out the depth of the neutral axis. So how to find out? Equate this FTC is equal to FTS. This is equal to this. So therefore, if you cross multiply, you'll get value of XU. So this is XU value we have. So if it XU is less than XU max, our section will be under reinforced. If XU is equal to XU max, section is balanced section. If XU is greater than XU max, section is over reinforced. If it is over reinforced, one thing what you can remember is that XU, we are going to take it as XU max. Next, after finding out the neutral axis where it is going to lie, next is we have to calculate the moment of resistance of a section. So now how to calculate? If the neutral axis, if it is going to lie within the flange, that is XU is less than DF, that is depth of the flange. Depth of the flange is this much. If this XU, it is going to lie in this, that means this is the neutral axis is going to lie in the flange. If this is the case, then it will be acting like a rectangular section. So in the previous videos, what we have done, same thing has to be done. By using same formulas, we have to calculate the XU value. Then next is MU based on this tension, or you can use this formula, or you can use this formula. So as to calculate the moment resistance capacity of the section. For a balanced or over reinforced section, instead of this XU, you can use XU max, and you can find out the moment resisting capacity of the section. This is similar to what we have done in the earlier classes. If this is the case, that is, if the neutral axis is going to lie in the flange, that is XU is less than DF, that means neutral axis is lying within the flange. It is same thing what we have done in the earlier classes. Next, if the neutral axis, if it is going to lie in the web, then we have to see there are different cases in this. We have to check depth of the flange if it is less than 3/7 XU. If that is the case, by using this formula, we have to calculate the moment resisting capacity of the section, either using this or this. If, for example, if the depth of the flange, if it is greater than 3/7 XU, only there will be slight change. Instead of this DF, we are going to have YF. Only this is the change we are going to have, that is YF. If DF is greater than 3/7 of XU, instead of here it was DF in the earlier equation, instead of this DF you will have YF. So YF is being calculated using this formula. Using this equation, we are going to calculate the moment resisting capacity of the section. Then next is if df by d, if it is less than or equal to 0.2, then this is the equation. If df by d, if it is greater than 0.2, this is the equation what we are going to use so as to calculate the moment resisting capacity of the section. So after seeing this, let us start with one problem and try to calculate the moment resisting capacity of the section. So in this example, they have given one T beam of effective flanged width width 1500 mm, that is BF we have, that is 1500 mm we have. Then next is we have thickness of slab, that is DF, that is equal to 100 mm. Then next is width of rib, that is BW, it is 300 mm. Effective depth is small d, that is 560 mm, is reinforced with 4 bars of 25 mm diameter bars. Calculate the factored moment of resistance. Use M20 grade concrete and Fe415 steel. This is the data which is being given. You can see now flange width it is 1500 mm, depth of the slab it is 100 mm, width of the web it is 300 mm, effective depth is 560 mm. This much data is being given. Then next is they have given 4 bars of 25 mm dia. So we'll calculate the area of steel. So area of one bar is pi by 4 into d square. So we have 4 bars multiplied by 4. So therefore it is 1964 mm square. This is the area of steel which is being provided. Then next is we'll try to find out what is the we are going to check where the neutral axis is going to lie, whether it is in flange or whether it is in web. So how to calculate now? We have to calculate value of this FTC and FTS, that is total compression and total tension. If total compression, if it is greater than FTS, then it is in neutral axis is going to lie in the flange. For that formula is 0.36 FCK into BF into DF, that is 0.36 FCK is 20, B width of the flange is 1500 mm, and depth of the slab is 100 mm. So it will be 1080. Total tension will be equal to 0.87 F of Y into AST. F of Y is 415 and AST is 1964. So it is 709 we have. So 1080, it is greater than 709. That is FTC is greater than FTS. Therefore, based on this, we can say that neutral axis is going to lie within the flange. Next is we'll try to calculate the depth of the neutral axis. So earlier we have used this formula itself, same thing has to be used for a rectangular section. As from this we'll come to neutral axis is lying in the flange, that means it will be like a rectangular section itself. The same thing what we have done in the earlier video, same thing, by using same thing we'll try to calculate the moment resisting capacity of the section. So x is equal to 0.87 f of I into ast divided by 0.36 fck into bf. If you substitute these values, we'll have answer as 65.65 mm. So if you check it with depth of the slab, that is 100 mm. So you can say that neutral axis is lying within the flange. Then next, how to calculate the and another thing is we have to check whether the section is under reinforced, balanced or over reinforced section. So XU max, how do you calculate? For Fe415 still it is 0.48 d. D is 560 mm, therefore it is 268.8 mm. So XU is less than XU max, therefore our section is under reinforced section. For under reinforced section, we can use this formula, that is 0.87 F of Y into AST into d minus 0.42 xu. So if you substitute this, we will get answer as 377.54 kilonewton meter. Or by using this equation also, you can calculate the moment resisting capacity of the section. Again, you will get the same answer, that is 377.5 kilonewton meter. So for example, if you see this annexure G of IS 456-2000 page number 96, you can see here now they have given one clause for XU less than DF. That means when the neutral axis is, it is going to lie in the flange, the moment resistance may be calculated using equation given in G1.1. G1.1 is here. That means it will be acting like a rectangular section. So therefore, based on this equation itself, we have calculated the XU by D or depth of the neutral axis. The next is, by using this equation, we have calculated the moment resisting capacity of the section. What equations I have used, it is already given in the IS code. Then next is, we'll try to see another problem. We have one T beam of effective flange width BF is equal to 1500 mm, thickness of the slab DF is equal to 100 mm, width of the rib BW is equal to 300 mm, effective depth small d is equal to 560 mm. We have 8 bars of 25 mm dia. We will be using M20 grade of concrete and 415 steel. So we have to calculate what is the moment resistant capacity of the section. So this is the data given. Now we have 8 bars of 25 mm dia. We will try to calculate the area of steel, that is pi by 4 into d square. D is nothing, how much? 25 square. Then multiplied by, we have 8 bars. Therefore it will be 3928 mm square. This is the area of steel which is provided. Then next, again we will check whether the neutral axis, it is going to lie in the flange or in web. So FTC is equal to 0.36 FCK into BF. So it will be 1080 kN. If total tension, it is 0.87 F of I into AST, it is 1418. So you can see here FTC, this is less than FTS. FTC is less than FTS. So therefore neutral axis is going to lie in the web. In the previous case, neutral axis was lying in the flange. Now if it is going to lie in the web, how to calculate the moment resistance capacity of the section? Then next, in this we have different cases. For that we'll try to check. First we'll try to check the depth of the neutral axis XU. We have to assume whether DF it is greater than 3/7 XU or DF is less than 3/7 of XU. So let us assume this case now first. That is, DF is less than 3/7 XU. Either we'll have this case or this case. So let us assume this case and we'll try to check whether. Then next is total compression. It is given by 0.36 FCK into BW into XU plus 0.446 FCK into BF into BW into DF. So FCK is 20. BW is width of the web, it is 300. XU, we'll keep it as it is. 0.446 we have, FCK is 20, BF is 1500, BW is 300, and DF is, depth of the slab is 100 mm. So if you simplify this, you will get it as 2160 XU, plus if you simplify this, you will get this value. Then next is, we will go to total tension, that is 0.87 F of I into AST, you will get 1418204. Then next we will equate this is equal to this and we will try to calculate the depth of the neutral axis, that is XU will be equal to 161 mm. If you equate this equation, that is equal to this equation. XU is equal to 161 mm. So if you take 3/7 of XU, 3/7 of XU means it will be 69 mm, which is less than depth of the flange, which is 100 mm. That means at initially we had assumed depth of the flange, it is greater than 3/7 XU. That means what assumption we have done, it is correct. So based on this, we'll try to do the further calculation. So when the DF, it is greater than 3/7 XU. So let me show you the code also. So you can see here they have given one in this clause they have given. So when DF by XU does not exceed 0.43, that is df by x is equal to 0.43, if df is equal to 0.43 xu, if it is going to exceed this, does not exceed this, we'll use this g2.2. I had shown you 3/7. 3/7 is nothing but 0.43 itself. Then next is, we are going to use equation g2.2.1 when df by xu exceeds 0.43. That means DF is greater than 3/7 XU. 0.43 is nothing but 3/7. You bring it this side, 3/7. df exceeds 3 by 7 xu. In this case, we have to use equation g2.2.1. g2.2.1 is nothing but this equation itself. So this equation is nothing but 0.36 xu max we have. So only change will be, instead of df we have to use yf. So what is the formula for yf? Already here they have given yf is equal to 0.15 xu plus 0.65 df. So same equation already I had shown in this, and we'll try to calculate. Therefore yf is equal to 0.15 xu plus 0.65 df. So if you substitute, you'll get it as 89.15, which is less than df. The next moment equation we have, moment resisting capacity. So this equation already I had shown in the code book. So same equation I have written here. The next is we have to substitute the value. That is, FCK is 20, we have width of the web is 300, XU is 161, D is 560, XU is 161.446, FCK, width of the flange that is 1500 mm, width of the web it is 300, YF is, just now we have calculated, 89.15, D is 560, 89.15 divided by 2. If you substitute, you will get answer as 63 kilonewton meter. Then next is, we'll see another problem. Determine the moment of resistance of the section shown in the figure. We are having M20 grade of concrete and Fe415 steel. So now what is the difference compared to the previous problem? Now if you see here, they have given reinforcement at the bottom as well as at the top. So that means this is a doubly reinforced section. So if this is the case, how to calculate the moment of resistance of the section? So we have to calculate now what is the area of steel in compression, ASC. ASC is nothing but here at the top. So here they have given 2 bars of 20 mm dia, that is pi by 4 into d square, that is 20 square multiplied by 2 bars we have. So therefore it is 628 mm square. Then next is, at the bottom we have area of steel in tension. How many bars we have? 5 bars of 25 mm dia. Pi by 4 into 25 square multiplied by 5. So AST will be 2455 mm square. Then next is, we will calculate, as it is a doubly reinforced section, we have to calculate D dash by D ratio. So D dash is nothing but the effective cover we have, which is 40 mm, which is being given. Therefore D dash is 40 mm. So effective depth, they have given it as 360 mm. So if you calculate, you will get value as 0.11. So based on this, you have to calculate the FSC value. So we have to refer SP16. So if you refer this SP16, so they have given one table, that is for stress in compression reinforcement, FSC, in doubly reinforced section. So you have to calculate D dash by D ratio, as it is nearly to this 0.11, and we have Fe415 steel. So therefore it is equal to 353 mm approximately. So therefore we'll use this, that is 353 newton per mm square. This is FSC value. Then next is, we'll try to determine the depth of location of the neutral axis. So formula is 0.36 FCK into BF into DF plus ASC into FSC. So it will be 941.684 newton. The next is, total tension will be equal to 0.87 FFI into AST. It is 886.37. So based on this, you can say FTC is greater than FTS. That means neutral axis is going to lie in the flange. If it is going to lie in the flange, that means again it will be like a rectangular section itself. So like the doubly reinforced section, what we have calculated, again based on that itself, like this equation, total compression, total tension, if you equate, you'll get value of XU, which is 92.3 mm. So XU is less than DF, therefore neutral axis is going to lie in the flange. So let us calculate the XU max. For Fe415 steel, it is 0.48 D, that is 172.8 mm. So XU is less than XU max, so therefore our section is under reinforced section. Then next is we have to calculate the moment resisting capacity of the section. Same formula already we have used, 0.36 FCK into BF into XU into D minus 0.4 to XU plus ASC into FSC into D minus of D dash. So if you substitute all these values, you will get answer as 284.4 kilonewton meter. Then next we will go to another problem. Determine the moment resisting capacity of the section for a given section. So here also there is a slight change. Here we have two bars of 20 mm dia. We will calculate the area of that bar. So here we have five bars of 25 mm dia. We will calculate the area of this bar. Again we will calculate d dash by d ratio. It is 0.11 itself. As we have calculated earlier, it will be 353 itself. Then next let us see what is the change in this problem. So we'll try to calculate FTC. The next is FTS. In this problem, what happens is that you can see FTC, it is less than FTS. In the previous case, this was FTC was greater than FTS. So now it is reversed. Then next, if this is the case, how to calculate? That means neutral axis is going to lie in the web. In the previous problem, neutral axis was lying in the flange. Then next is again, if it is going to lie in the web, we have to check DF greater than 3/7 XU, or if it is less than 3/7 XU, that has to be checked. So first let us assume like DF, it is greater than 3/7 XU. If that is the case, you have to take YF value, that is 0.15 XU plus 0.65 DF. So therefore total compression is this equation. You substitute, you will get value of FTC, that is this equation we'll have. Then next we'll take total tension, 88,886,378 newton we have. So equate this equation is equal to this equation, you'll get value of XU. So if you equate, you'll get value of XU, that is 161 mm. So if you see 3/7 of XU, it is 69 mm, which is less than DF. That means we had assumed that DF, it is greater than 3/7 XU. That means what assumption we have done, it is okay. So by using that formula itself, we can calculate the moment resisting capacity. Therefore, YF will be equal to 89.15 mm. So by using that equation itself, M is equal to 0.36 FCK. This equation we are going to have. So instead of only DF, this will be YF. So if you substitute, you will get value as 275.58 kilonewton meter. Then next we will see another problem, that is calculate the amount of reinforcement for the following flange section. So in the previous problems, if you see, the area of reinforcement was given to us. They used to calculate the moment of resistance of the section. But here in this problem, the moment is given to us. They are asking us what reinforcement we should put in the given beam section. That is the change. So they have given width of the flange, depth of the flange, total depth they have given, width of the web they have given, FCK they have given, and FP415 they have given. Based on this, we'll try to calculate how much steel we have to put in the given section. So this is the data which is being given in this. The next is we have to calculate now AST, that is nothing but AST1 plus AST2. So we'll assume effective cover, that is 50 mm. So total depth is 400 mm capital D. So if you want to calculate effective depth, that is 400 minus of 50 mm. So therefore it will be 350 mm we have. The next is we have to calculate this DF by D ratio. That is 100 is nothing but depth of the slab divided by 350, it is 0.28. DF by D, it is greater than 0.2. DF by D, it is greater than 0.2. So therefore moment equation will be this. As DF by D equation is this, moment equation will be this. So therefore XU by D, that is equal to 0.48. So therefore XU max will be equal to 168 mm. So therefore YF will be equal to 0.15 XU max plus 0.65 DF, that is 90.2. The next is, by substituting here in this equation, we can calculate the value of mu lim, that is limiting moment, that is 162 into 10 raised to 6. 162 we have. Therefore, this, if you see, mu is greater than mu lim. So moment given was, if you see the problem, moment given was 250. 250 we have. This is 250 we have. So limiting moment value is how much? 162 mm we have. 162 mm we have. This is 250. Moment which is coming on this beam is greater than the limiting moment. If this is the case, what we have to do? We have to go for doubly reinforced section. If it is less, we can design it as a singly reinforced section. So if we have a doubly reinforced section, how to calculate now? Again, same thing, mu lim is equal to 0.87 FFI into ST into D minus of DF by 2. So therefore, AST1, already these formulas we have seen, mu lim divided by 0.87 FFI into D minus of DF. If you substitute, you will get answer as 1496 mm square. Then next is mu2. These already, these formulas already they are given in the code book also, you can refer. So mu minus mu is 250 minus mu lim is 88. So this much moment, additional moment has to be resisted by the additional compressive reinforcement and additional tensile reinforcement. So additional tensile reinforcement, that is AST2 is equal to mu2 divided by 0.87 FFI into D minus D dash. So if you substitute, it is 812 mm square. The next is total area of steel in tension, that is AST1 plus AST2. If you add up this 1496 plus 812, that will be equal to 32308 mm square. So now how many bars we have to provide? So let us assume, we'll assume that we are using 25 mm diameter bar. So area of one bar is how much? Pi by 4 into D square. That is 25 square. It is nearly around 490. 490, let me check, pi by 4 into D square. It is nearly 490. So 490, if you provide 5 bars, means it will be 2454. So it is greater than 2308. So therefore, what we can do? We can provide 5 bars of 25 mm diameter. Then next is, we have to calculate ASC value, D dash by D value. You can have 50 by 350, that is 0.142. So directly you can use the table also, just for what I had shown. Let me show you once again. So you can see here, it is 0.14. It is like somewhere here in between. So if you calculate, if you interpolate these values, you will get answer as 346 Newton per mm square, FSC value. So ASC is equal to mu2 divided by FSC into D minus of D dash. Based on this, we'll come to know what is the area of compression reinforcement, that is 848 mm square. So for this, how many bars we can provide? So we can assume 25 mm bar. That means it is going to have area of 490. So 490, if you provide 2 bars, that is 492 into 2, nearly like 1000 itself, or something like 980. So our requirement is 848, so it is greater than that. So therefore, we will provide 2 bars of 25 mm diameter.